offering is the truth.
Nothing more. Hast thou with him spread out the sky, which is strong and as a molten looking glass?
I know we have still not shattered that highest and hardest glass ceiling, but someday someone will, and hopefully sooner than we might think right now. Although we weren't able to shatter that highest, hardest glass ceiling this time, thanks to you, it's got about 18 million cracks in it. Shining through like never before.
Johnston Island was the center of launch and experimental activity for the 1962 high-altitude weapon effects testing termed Operation Fishbowl. Radiating out in all directions from this tiny island, 800 miles southwest of Hawaii, were instrumented stations, 266 of them. Within the limited confines of Johnston Island itself, the operations testing and support facilities were crowded into every spare niche, including space between the existing Air Force Station plant and buildings, with some apparatus and offices crammed into World War II bomb shelters, including the scientific readiness team, task force control personnel, and launch control units. At the northwestern end of the island was the Thor launch complex, joined later by Nike Hercules and Stripey units, plus a second Thor pad. Fishbowl's line of more than 30 instrument rocket launchers with attendant checkout facilities were sandwiched between the island's runway and the shore. Standing offshore were 9 instrumented test ships, vital links in the fishbowl effort, including the DAMP ship, acronym for Downrange Anti-Missile Measurements Program Ship, American Mariner. Fiji's jet airport at Nandi was the operating base for 3 fishbowl aircraft. On each event, a KC-135 and 2 RC-121s. In the Pacific, as part of the hardtack series, 3 effect shots, yucca, orange, and teak, were detonated at respectively 26, 43, 77 kilometers. On Operation Fishbowl, nuclear detonations rent the sky 5 times over the Johnston Island area, each time during the hours of darkness. Of the 5 fishbowl shots, the highest burst was the 400-kilometer Starfish event, launched by a pod-carrying Thor missile. Its yield was 1.4 megatons. In addition to the local phenomena, the transport of bomb debris and other charged particles in the magnetic field produced colorful aurora arcing into the northern and southern conjugate regions. Some rockets, launched in conjunction with the burst, were positioned in time and space to chart radar transmission paths through the burst environment. The aim was to help establish the space-time parameters, also for each event. Existing military operational communications links throughout the Pacific area were monitored to determine the disruptive effects caused by the fishbowl bursts.
Thank you.
With America now of necessity peering skyward in its quest for security, the results gleaned from 1962's high-altitude operation contribute both to this safeguard role and to scientific enlightenment on the effects of the atom above the atmosphere.
Broke the dome.
All I'm offering is the truth.